Welcome to the 7th episode of F1 2013 Career Mode. This time we're in Montreal and in Canada. And we're ready to go. Managed to qualify in 4th, which is excellent. The 4th in. This is probably one of my strongest laps tracks on the F1 2013 Canada. So it'll be a good race, hopefully. Hopefully at the first corner I'm usually quite strong, so I should be able to take a lot of positions. I apologise if I keep hiccuping in this commentary. They should go halfway through, or maybe more. I've had them a while, so they should go soon. There you go, there was another one. So anyway, heading out to the grid now. In our Force India. And there you go, we've got Lewis Hamilton first. Me in fourth. There's a massive one that one time. And my teammate down in 12th, so it shows it is my driving, not the performance of the car, which is good here. But a bit of both. Then go straight onto Rich to give me the best advantage at the first corner, which is probably the most crucial corner in the race. So here we go, lights are out and off we go. Just keep gaining up the positions already. Gaining position on Alonso, which is unusual because I'm usually quite bad at starting. I'm going to break as late as I can. It's going to be close. Diving up the inside, in between the two. Cutting Lewis Hamilton out straight away, and there we've got Vettel there. Eases away from me here. It's coming to turn two, or three, whatever it's called. Here you go, still sustaining the position, which is good, and we're still weaving our way through these next few corners, which is really, really good. Yeah, guys, so we've almost got 30 subscribers, which is quite a bit, so if we get 100, that'll be like a special video, I don't know, or 50, probably that'll be a special video. So yeah, we'll see. There we go, so as we just finished bouncing over these turns, you see the pack's already starting to begin to pull away, as you can see on the mini-map. In the bottom left, running on Rich. The Rich probably won't last long. Probably last until the end of this lap. But this is it. I'm staying first. You don't really have to defend much, actually. I actually pull away quite a bit. So I'm just going to have lap 8 out of 18, which is our pit stop lap. Here it comes popping up there, saying I've got a pit. I think I should have pit the lap before, but I felt I didn't need to until there. That shaped my decision to pit this lap. All as you can see on the mini-map, all the other cars have pitted. Those little two blocks further away, they haven't. It's the ones behind it that we're worried about. As you can see, I'm like 14 seconds ahead of Hamilton, who's in second. I think they might be backmarkers. We're going to bomb into the pits, which should save me a lot of time. This is a very, very quick pit stop because you don't have to brake for that corner or the first chicane. Okay, as we come out now, changing the tyres. Excellent tyre stop, and out we go. Nobody to stop us as the tyres are really cold, but we should be able to warm them up in a lap or two. That's flashing blue, which means the cars are close. I can't see him to my right. If you see him to your right, you know you've got to be careful coming out of here. But I can't see him at all. Go a bit aggressive, just run one tyre on the grass, but that's alright. Just going to keep pushing on now. Okay, as we keep moving up the pack, I'm 3.2 seconds ahead of Hamilton at the line, which is really good. You can see the gap the leaders have broke to the cars behind and my teammate, which is really good. Okay, so we're going to just keep on going through these next few corners now. Warming up the tyres. The tyres haven't got the most grip. You see, gained half a second in that corner, in those few corners alone. So he'll probably get DRS in the next few corners, no doubt. He'll probably close up on me a bit more, which isn't really what we want him to do. But we'll keep going. He might not get DRS. He might just be a second out. We'll see. Okay, as we break for the hairpin, it's probably, in my opinion, one of the most annoying. Second most annoying. The first one's at Monaco, as you saw in the Monaco video. If you haven't watched that, go back and watch that. That's a pretty good one to watch. Changing up gears now, so we're going to switch. I'm in first, and I should be able to stay with first now till the end of the race, which should be quite good. Bombing over these chicanes. You can in this game, as long as you keep out the wall, which is good. Okay, now, so we're going to switch to lap 18 out of 18. We're going to switch to lap 18 out of 18. This time, okay, so coming down the back straight, I'm in first. All I've got to do now is defend from Hamilton. You can see the massive, huge gap. If it gives us like 10 more laps, I'll probably be able to catch up to the cars in front. The tyres aren't really going. They could go forever on this track. They're really not really a very tyre-degrading track. You see Vettel should finish in second, Hamilton in third, and me in first to get my first race victory. Excellent, at Force India. Nobody ever expected that on expert difficulty. Next one is legend. I don't want to put it on legendary, I'll get destroyed. So expert is probably my level where it's at, which is really good. And she finished first there. You see the massive gap. My teammate still not on the board, still not to be seen. So I get 20G, first podium finish, which is really, really good. Sam Rich got to fourth, back up to the tragic last race at Monaco that we had. Wasn't really the best. But that means fourth, Celia back up to fourth in the constructors as well, which is exactly where we want to be. So let's see, me getting out of the car. Really, really happy here. Hey, climbing out of the car. Don't know why they put the steering wheel back, but well. There you go. My lovely helmet, might change it. Lock in some new ones with RaceNet. There you go, as you can see, Vettel will probably come up to now to me and greet me and hit me on the shoulder like they do in F1 2012. There you go. They haven't changed that at all. Vettel's eyes look a bit weird. But anyway, we'll leave out for another video, and I'll see you guys next video. See ya.